Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech HaOlam, Shehakol Nihyeh Bidvaro. The most prominent among the 12 sons of Jacob, many say, were Judah and Joseph. Each one had his own characteristics, his own personality. Let us analyze for a moment, because there is a tradition in Judaism that says that there are two messiahs. One is a descendant of Joseph, and one is a descendant of Judah. What is the difference between these two? Well, Joseph was a very special individual. He is in the house of Potiphar, and Potiphar trusts him, makes him the ruler of the entire house when he is away. But the wife of Potiphar finds him attractive, and she offers herself sexually to Joseph. Joseph refuses, because he says, how can he do this to his master? His master has all his trust placed in him, and he's going to betray him with his wife. He refuses, and because of it, he lands in jail. And he spends many years in jail, but he is able to get out of jail because he's very capable. And he interprets the dreams of two people in jail, and eventually he interprets the very famous dream of Pharaoh about the seven cows, the lean cows, the fat cows, and he saves Egypt from hunger. Later on, his brothers have to come and buy food from him. He sees his brothers in front of him. He is now the ruler of Egypt, second only to Pharaoh. He can have them killed. He can have them put in jail. He could have done anything with them as he wished. But instead, no. Joseph eventually reveals himself to them, and he says, forget about what you did. It's actually the hand of God. This is destiny. God wanted me to be the agent to save everybody, the Egyptians and the Jewish people as well. It's not your fault. He could have done something else. You know, he seems to be such a just man. He's almost a saint. As a matter of fact, in Jewish tradition, you refer to Joseph as Joseph the Saint, because he refused the advances of the wife of Potiphar and how he treated his brothers. So he's really an ideal human being, and maybe very worthy of being the ancestor of a Messiah that will eventually save all of humanity. What about his brother Judah? His brother Judah has a different personality. Judah, when the brothers want to kill Joseph by throwing him into a pit, he suggests, you know what, why should we have blood on our hands? Let's sell him as a slave. Afterwards, the brothers reason and say, you know, had this Judah told us to free him, maybe we would have freed him. Why did he say to us that we should sell him as a slave? Judah disappears from the scene. He goes to another place. He marries a woman, has three sons. His oldest son gets married to a woman by the name of Tamar, but his oldest son dies. So then the second son becomes the husband of Tamar. But the third son never becomes the husband of Tamar. And Tamar wants to have a child in order to have the name of her first husband perpetuated. And after the wife of Judah dies, she disguises herself as a harlot, as a prostitute. And Judah, when he sees her, he requires her services, and he gives her some items that he has, personal items, in payment, because he had no money with him. She becomes pregnant, and the law then is she committed adultery. She should therefore be burned to death. But at the last moment, she says, you know who is the father of my child? The person who is the owner of these elements. Judah says, she is really more righteous than I am. Those are my things. I am really the father of that child. Judah committed a very indecent type. He had an indecent type of behavior. He had relations with a prostitute. But at the end, he recognizes that he is really the father. He could very well have said nothing, and the woman would have been burnt, and that would have been the end of the story. But he assumes responsibility. And now, later on, when he is in front of Joseph with his youngest brother, Benjamin, and he is responsible for Benjamin, he says, you know what? If you're going to put Benjamin in jail, put me in jail. He offers himself in jail instead of Benjamin. So you see, Judah is a different type of personality. He's not a saint. He commits mistakes. But afterwards, he looks for a way in order to make things good again. He made a mistake. Well, let me show some remorse. Let's see what we can do instead. So we have two different types. One is a saint that never commits any errors. The other one is someone who does commit errors, but later on he tries to make amends. He tries to make life good. Once again, to show remorse, to show penitence for what he did. And maybe that is why the second Messiah, the descendant of Judah, is the Messiah that will save us. Because we are all like that. We commit errors. We do sins. But the important thing is, are we able afterwards for teshuva? Teshuva means start once again going back to the roots. Do the right thing after you made a mistake. Maybe that is why the real Messiah that will save this world is the one that is a descendant of Judah, because we are more like him. Well, in one sense, we are ready to make mistakes. Ein Adam, our rabbis say, there is no man in this world that doesn't make mistakes. But the important thing is, do we recognize our mistake? Are we ready for teshuvah? Are we ready for remaking our lives so in the future we don't make the same mistake? And that is actually the challenge to all of us. We have made mistakes, but are we ready to do something to erase the mistakes that we made?